Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're here on Asana and we're going to be actually demonstrating to you the new list layouts which are available through Asana. We'll actually be playing around with some of the custom fields, how they work, how it compares to some of the other project management applications, and we're also going to be diving into a few of the other updates that Asana has released over the last couple of weeks. If you are looking for a full Asana tour, then you can definitely check out the 30-minute feature that we did, and we'll make sure to include it in the link in the description. So if you're looking at a 2019 full overview of the basic Asana plan, then you can get that there. We are planning to do a premium Asana feature very soon. But as you can imagine, let's dive into today's video, but before we do that, a little word from our sponsor. Do you feel overwhelmed by emails? Then Sanebox might be a handy tool for you. Now, Sanebox helps you to manage emails using artificial intelligence. It'll magically manage your email into a Sane Later folder, which lets you focus on the important stuff in your main inbox. If you find an email in the wrong folder, just move it and it'll learn each time, training your inbox to be smarter and more effective. There's nothing to install, nothing to learn, and the best thing is that it works with any email service you already use. I currently use it with Missive. Now, we've had Sanebox on before as a sponsor, and they are back again. This is one of the tools I paid for on a monthly basis and can't recommend trying it enough. I actually upgraded to their annual plan back in July. You guys can get a 2-week free trial and $25 credit by visiting sanebox.com/keepproductive today. That's sanebox.com/keepproductive. I really hope you enjoy this one, guys. Happy emailing. Okay guys, here we are with the project templates. And before we begin, I just wanted to shout this out because obviously this is pretty attractive as a way to start a project. So if I go back, you want to start a project, you just hit new project. And as you can see here, you have a range of project templates. So what's quite good is you can set it to the various different sort of layouts that you traditionally have, like marketing, product. In this case, I could choose marketing and it would bring up some common layouts that might be suitable, like a content calendar, an event planning, and maybe marketing project plan. And as you can see below, you've got a little bit of a preview, like list layout. This is mainly going to be the list layout that you're going to be utilizing. And for example, with creative requests, that's going to be board because that's a very visual experience that you want to manage. And you can obviously change. You can go to HR. For example, here you can see a range of different things like company, conference agenda, grant tracking, interview questions. You could have all here. But we'll come back to this because I want to showcase what a working list layout might look like to you, but we're going to go ahead and start a blank project. So obviously when you create a project inside of your Asana, you get to give it a title, new applicant tracker, and you can use a description if you want to. So we're actually going to utilize a list view, and we're actually just keep it public to Francesco. Obviously this is slightly different. If you're on the basic plan, you won't have the option to change the timeline, for example, and you won't have the option to privatize to certain project members. But if I went to private to project members, I can. And as you can see, it takes a little bit of time to load up, but you do have that new timeline view, which I'm sure we'll touch on in another video, but it's actually one thing that a lot of people like. So for example, what you can start doing is adding tasks down here. And it's not just tasks you can add what's called sections. So you could say here, you could, you know, applied, people who have applied, and you can add a section here who we're interviewing. So as you can see, these sections help you to separate some of the work. It's very similar to the groups function inside of monday.com, and other experiences have this within it. But if I wanted to, I could add a task, and let's say I'm interviewing Chad Wells, who is an interview candidate, and naturally I can open up the details there and find out, you know, for example, what stage is in, what section it's in, and that actually helps when it comes to the board view, because once you're adding these sections, they essentially equate to columns, and you can move people across the relevant statuses. So one thing that you'll have inside of the basic Asana plan is the ability, if for example, you want to add an assignee to the task. So for example, I could assign myself to this person. I'm interviewing Chad Wells, and a date. You can add a due date, for example, the Thursday. But obviously you can ascend and descend the order, but this is where the premium comes in handy. So all you have to do is go up here to add a field. Now, this is similar to what many of the other applications, I believe Zenkit does this, Notion does this, as a way to add new properties and make it a bit more customized when you're trying to track the process or importance of a candidate. Okay guys, so there we are. If I wanted to add it to the library, you can do so there. So for example, if I go ahead and create that as a field, you can now see that pops up there and I can give this interview a rating. Now, for example, I might want to say, actually, you know, Chad Wells is a wild card. I can add another field as well. So you could use this numbers field as a way to calculate maybe how many years experience they have. So for example, I could have years experience. And you could give yourself the decimal places, and that could be anything in there. So that's quite handy. So you can actually be like, okay, you can do it based on two decimal places. But in this case, we actually don't need that. Actually, maybe one decimal place. So if I go ahead and create this new field, I could say, okay, Chad has 2.5 years experience. So you can start to get an idea of how well he is experienced. So I really like the way this is laid out. It's very simple. Obviously, I can go in and see more details if I want to, and I can see all of those fields there available. Now, this is very similar to the custom fields that are available through Trello, say, but what I quite like about this is you have this in a really attractive, simple view. Now, if I were to go over to boards, you can see here that obviously it sets it based on what we created before, the sections, but you can go up here to the fields and you can have the fields on or off. So for example, if you want to, you know, see the details, like whether it's a wild card, whether how many years experience they've got, you can have those all on, which is very helpful. You can also go up to sort and you could sort it based on obviously due date, assignee, alphabetical order, or years of progress. So for example, you could see and be very specific about what you see. So this is something that a lot of people like to be able to go from the list view to the actual board view and actually see that. Now, if you are able to, you can go back. And what's quite nice is if you want to see the fields, for example, what project it's associated to, you can add a project to it, you can add a tag. So once you go to that field, they will obviously work across the different layouts, which is handy. So if you dock one off one, then the other one will show up with that same experience. So the one thing you can do is if you want to save a layout as a default, you can have that there. And obviously that will help you come back to the default later. So that's a very useful way to come back to that. Now, if I want to, I can use the timeline view to get a picture of where and when I'm interviewing this candidate. I can even go across multiple dates, which is something I know obviously a lot of people want to do when they're interviewing is have them across multiple dates. And as you can see, this list view changes along with that. So it will go and maneuver between the 24th and 27th of October. Now, this is really easy to add more and more details. You can add section headers and even milestones, targets that you want to reach for your success in terms of this project or campaign. Let's go and see some of the pre-created project templates that have this list being utilized. So let's go to the new project and let's stick with the same theme of HR. So let's go ahead and let's organize a fundraising event planning. Now, as you can see, you can actually see what available features are inside of your package. So in premium, you actually have, you know, all of the views, the list, the boards, the calendar, and the custom fields. And this is a preview of what you will see. And if I go ahead and create the project, it's all laid out for me. I can actually begin assigning something to someone, add a due date, which is typical. And also I can actually use the proposed budget, which for example could be $3,000 say, and I could use the priorities here. So the one thing that I've not noticed is whether there is a way to see a running total of the information. I know in apps like Notion, you can see the sum and maybe the count of each of the, I don't know, independent fields, like how many highs there are, how many lows there are. But that's probably something they are probably looking to add as they grow this there. And there is a send feedback button there if you do want to find out more details about that. So guys, that was a little bit of an overview of the list view. Now you're probably wondering what new things have Asana got out. Now, if you want, just before we roll into that, if you want to take a look at what the old look looked like, I'll include a guide in the description below. It's very similar to things like ClickUp and Monday.com. It's aiming at this grid-like structure to help you to organize. Now, Asana have also released an automations feature, allowing you to produce rules for each of your different projects or even boards or lists, and help you to manage some of the smaller processes there. So I'll include the article about that below. Inside of this list view update, they also included updated CSV importer that helps improve CSV imports into Asana projects. The subtask visibility has also improved, as well as inbox filters for drilling down on what you want to see inside of your inbox. That comes in terms of notifications, and a slightly polished off iOS application. I will include that link and that blog post in the description, but you should have this new list view, this new clutter-free list view available from the 9th of October. So guys, I really hope you found some value in this, and please do let me know in the description below or the comments below whether you have any questions, and I look forward to some of your thoughts on this new Asana list view. Anyway guys, a big thank you, and I'll talk to you guys super duper soon. Cheers everyone.